Hello there, my RPG lovers, and welcome to another video. Forsaken Realms Varin's Call is an upcoming story-driven RPG. It's been a while since I talked about Varin's Call on the channel, and I promised you that I'm going to keep my eye on this game. Varin's Call is one of my most anticipated RPGs for a reason. The first time I saw the trailer for this game, I got some major Outward vibes, and that's when I really got interested in Varin's Call. It was actually called Forsaken Realms Exodus Rising back then, but they decided to rename the game to Varin's Call, and I think it definitely sounds better. If you watched my channel back in 2019, you know that I extensively covered Outward on my channel. The artistic style of Varin's Call is very similar, and even the gameplay looks kinda similar to Outward. To be honest, the gameplay in Varin's Call looks better, but we obviously don't know how it actually feels to play the game. Anyway, I'm going to talk about everything you know about this game so far, including all the recent updates they posted on social media and their website. So let's jump right in. Varin's Call is set in a fantasy world called Leda. This will be a semi-open world game, according to developers. What that actually means, you're going to have several different zones to explore, and some of them are more open than others. These areas don't look huge by any means, but all of them seem very interesting and fun to explore. As far as I could tell, we're not going to have mounts, and exploration is done by foot, so the size of the world seems fine for that kind of exploration. As we progress through the main story, more zones will become available to explore. The game is supposed to have boss fights before you unlock a new zone. The city of Varin has an interesting concept, and it kinda reminds me how the exploration in Gothic games work. The city is divided in two different areas, and you have to work a bit before you get to unlock the upper city, which is exactly how Gothic games works. Besides the city of Varin, you'll be able to explore different unique looking areas. It seems like the game has a decent amount of different looking biomes. One of my favorite clips is about the starting area called Baratrum Forest. The aesthetic of this place is just amazing. The overgrown aesthetic of the environment makes this place a joy to watch, it seems very immersive. We can see the same overgrown aesthetic in the city as well. Even the buildings have this overgrown style, which looks very cool if you ask me. Then we have some dungeons, snow area, and some clips from other explorable places. The immersion seems like a big focus of the game. Varin's Call has a very vibrant color palette and a semi-cartoony art style. The majority of these environments have a fantasy look, while the character models have a more realistic style to them. Speaking of which, there is a very good character creation system in the game, and the character models look pretty good. They made some huge improvements with the character models, they used to look a lot different. The soundtrack that plays in the background is another reason why I think the game seems very immersive. It's a very good soundtrack and quite fitting for this fantasy RPG. I got a couple of unique samples. We don't have a ton of info about the story of the game. You're playing as a mercenary who is traveling towards the war-torn city of Varin. The Kraak Swarm has invaded the city of Varin, which left some pretty serious consequences. The armies of the city were left decimated, and most people fled home to their own lands. Only few defenders remain, fighting to reclaim their beloved city. Besides the main story, we can expect to find some side quests in all areas. We are still not sure how the quest will work in general, but it seems like your standard RPG stuff. That will be everything we currently know about the story. After all, this is a story-driven RPG, so I guess they want to keep the spoilers to minimum. Although I would like to hear a bit more about the main story and characters in one of their future updates. So what about the gameplay? Well, I'm glad you asked. The gameplay in Varin's Call has pretty much everything you would expect to see in a fantasy action RPG. We have melee, ranged and magic playstyles, and a leveling system that seems very similar to Skyrim. In one of the devlogs on their official YouTube channel, they said that your attributes will increase the more you use them. For example, the more you jump, run and dodge, your stamina will gradually increase. I always liked the idea of this system, but it can also create a weird meta gameplay where you find yourself constantly spamming these abilities in order to increase your attributes. Jumping like a maniac in Oblivion comes to mind. However, we still don't know a lot about this system, so we'll have to wait and see. As for the spells and abilities, they decided to scatter them throughout the world. You'll be able to loot them by exploring or buy them at specific merchants. To tell you the truth, I'm not a huge fan of this progression system. I would always prefer a more traditional RPG progression where you can choose which abilities or spells to get. But we'll see, maybe they do it in a very interesting way. And like I said, the world is not huge, so I guess finding these abilities and spells won't be tedious. The melee gameplay looks better and better with each new update. It seems very solid for a game of this type and the hitboxes look precise. We obviously don't know how it feels to control the character. That will be one of the key factors when it comes to combat. But I would say the combat passes the eye check in terms of animations and how it looks in general. The enemies you're going to fight look like they have decent animations. Some of the melee abilities that we could see also look pretty fun to use. The game has a bunch of different weapon types and they all seem to have unique attack animations. In a recent update, we can see some of the new animations for Battle Axe and the Warhammer. Here we have another clip where they showcase different melee abilities. I'm pretty sure I'm going for a two-handed sword playthrough when the game comes out. The armor sets and weapons look very good, even from the very old footage of the game. In some of the recent updates, they've been focusing on improving the elemental effects that we can find on weapons. Speaking of updates, in the most recent social media posts, we can see a couple of clips that focus on stealth gameplay. The backstabs are a thing in this game, and it seems like you can play as an assassin. Besides the regular weapon types, your character will get some gadgets like traps that you can even activate with your ranged weapon. The ranged gameplay looks pretty good as well. You can use a bow, a crossbow, or go for a magic playstyle. The game will try to encourage you to mix your playstyles, judging from all the clips I've seen. The bow and arrow gameplay looks pretty good, especially in recent updates. The player is using some kind of poison arrows in this clip, and the sound effect for the impact is very beefy. In another clip, we can see a lot more arrow types, so it's safe to say that range gameplay will have some depth. I wanna play with a bow and a two-handed sword, so I'm curious how that's going to work. I'm guessing it's going to work fine because, like I said before, the attributes will increase upon use. Besides different arrow types, you can use magic to put different effects on your weapons. But that's only one of the features of the magic playstyle. We can see various spells in new and older clips. They said they can't wait to show us how magic actually works, so I'm expecting to see more info about magic soon. The spells we can see in some recent updates look very powerful, and it seems like you can totally play a pure mage in this game. However, like I said, since we can see that you can combine a bunch of different abilities and playstyles, I'm guessing that's going to be the optimal way to fight enemies. I'm just wondering about different bosses in the game and how many mechanics they're going to have. Another thing that I really like is how you can use the environment to your advantage, like we can see here. Some RPGs don't allow you to play with the terrain like this because the NPCs will get stuck on the ledge. And the last recent update I want to mention is about the NPCs. Now, if you remember the last video I did for Warren's Call, I mentioned how the game won't have any voice acting. Well, that's not actually true. The camera perspective switches when you're talking to NPCs and they will have voice acting. I'm not sure to what extent, but even if not all dialogue lines are voice acted, it's still better than no voice acting at all. This is a story-driven RPG after all, and having voice acting will make the game even more immersive. That'll be everything I wanted to talk about in this video. You can still find a lot of smaller updates that I didn't mention in this video by following Warren's Call on YouTube or Twitter. We still don't have an exact release date, but the game is now in beta, if I'm not mistaken. So I wouldn't be surprised if you get a release date soon-ish. I'm really looking forward to play this game, and you can definitely expect me to cover it with at least a couple of videos and possibly a stream or two. Like I said, it gives me some major outward vibes, and it looks like a really cozy RPG in general. Anyway, tell me your impressions about Warren's Call in the comments below. I just launched my personal store, where you can buy some interesting t-shirts and hoodies. Check out some cool designs in the theme of the channel, like this RPG Zone hoodie or Nameless Hero t-shirt. But you'll find a lot more if you follow the link in the description. I think that's a great way to get something back for supporting the channel. And of course, you can always become a Patreon or a YouTube member and get your name on the end credits of my videos. Many thanks to all of my current supporters, and I'll see you in the next one.